Before performing the static alignment, an accurate bench alignment of the prosthesis has to be done. It is very important to pay attention to a possible hip flexion contracture of the user. If so, it has to be properly accommodated for according to the alignment recommendation in X-Soft. After tightening the screws with the adequate torque levels, the prosthesis can be donned and the computer-assisted alignment can be started by clicking on the Static tab. Pay attention to the pop-up warning message and then let the user stand up. Even if the knee joint is flexed, it will still be locked against flexion during the measurement process. It is also possible to go to the Static Alignment tab after the user stands up. Evaluate the built-in socket flexion by means of the triple test. Here the foot tips should be placed nearly on the same line. If the prosthetic foot is clearly anterior to the contralateral side, this can be a sign that not enough socket flexion was considered. To achieve a valid measurement, some criteria have to be fulfilled. The knee joint must be fully extended. Both legs should be equally loaded, but the prosthesis must be loaded with at least 35% of body weight. It is very important for the accuracy of the measurement to tighten the screws of the Axon tube adapter to 15 Nm. The sensors in the tube only work correctly when the screws have been tightened to exactly this value. Keep that in mind every time the alignment of the foot is changed. The user should look straight ahead and the arms should be hanging at the sides. Check the measurement criteria again and trigger the measurement. In addition to the field with a percentage of body weight, three further fields are visible on the left side. The first field shows the value for the distance between the knee center and the ground reaction force. If the ground reaction force is positioned too far anterior, it is possible that the foot is too plantar flexed. The ground reaction force must not fall behind the knee center because this would initiate knee flexion during standing. The second field shows the distance between the middle of the prosthetic foot and the ground reaction force. When the force is anterior to the middle of the foot, there is more pressure on the forefoot and the plantar flexion can probably be reduced. If the force is too posterior, there is probably too much dorsiflexion. The third field shows the measured horizontal force. The horizontal force should fall between 0 and minus 2% of body weight. A positive horizontal force should not occur with the exception of bilateral fittings. In this case, it is normal that the left and right side counterbalance each other. In general, the goal is to keep horizontal forces as small as possible. In addition to the three measurement fields, a live measurement of the shank inclination and the ground reaction force and its horizontal part is displayed on the right side of the software. The shank inclination is additional valuable information for optimizing the static alignment. For example, a backwards inclination of the shank is a sign for an insufficient prosthetic alignment. In this case, the ground reaction force is too anterior and the negative horizontal force is too large. A good static alignment is achieved when all three fields are green. Sometimes a yellow field can be acceptable but is not ideal. The two most common causes for this unsatisfactory result are: the hip flexion contracture was not sufficiently accommodated in the prosthetic alignment and there is not enough socket flexion, or the plantar flexion at the foot has not been correctly adjusted. Plantar flexion is now being reduced by 1/4 turn. It is recommended to note all of the alignment changes so that 1 or 2 steps can be undone if necessary. It is very helpful to have the opportunity to review the static alignment process later. Do not forget to tighten the screws to 15 Newton meters again and check the ground reaction force in X-Soft. As shown in the computer-assisted alignment, the horizontal force is reduced and the distance between the middle of the foot and the ground reaction force has improved. Nevertheless, a further plantar flexion reduction is necessary. The measurement has been improved now and the static alignment optimization has been finished. Let the user take some steps and check the values again. With a click on this button, the knee joint switches into basic mode. The user can now walk and there is no need to leave the static alignment tab. After 10 steps, the Genium has done a self-calibration and a second check of the computer-assisted alignment is recommended. After this step, static alignment is completed and the dynamic alignment process can begin.